marido. 150 pesos, cielito lindo me han ofrecido para ponerle cuernos, cielito lindo, a tu marido. Si ay, 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 si ay, 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 si que me ponen, aunque me den 50, cielito lindo, yo se los pongo. The next song, the next
2 a.m.
Okay. The next song we're gonna play is a song in the minor key. So this style of music, it's called Son Huasteco. It's from the region. It's kind of hard to like point on a map. It's central eastern Mexico, and it encompasses like 6 different states within Mexico. But the music is not played throughout that whole state. For example, in the state of Veracruz, the Huasteco region is just like the most northern part of the state. So it's kind of spread out in a weird area of Mexico. It's very regional, the music. You can't just like fly to Veracruz and then listen to this. You gotta know like the spots, and you gotta know where to go and the communities to head to. A lot of them are high altitude, in the boonies, maybe in the jungle. Fillmore is one of Fillmore. Well, I think we've established Fillmore as a part of the Huasteca. So, Central, Eastern Mexico and Fillmore. So this next song is one of the minor songs in this genre of music. It's called El Gallo. You guys know what a gallo is?
Yeah.
So this one's called El Gallo. Play is actually not a son or a huapango. It even precedes huapangos and sones. It's an old wedding march, and we're gonna sing it in the Aztec language of Nahuatl. The song is called Xochipitzahuac, which means blossoming or blooming flower. Is it still spring?
Yes.
It's still spring, right? So it's very fitting.
Well, those, mind you, I'll talk to your mom later.
So I'll check pizza. Siblings and transition to a different genre of Mexican son. The last song that we're going to play is El Bus, La Basanga. You know what? La Basanga is on one of our CDs that I think is for sale. So. Is that how you're supposed to plug CDs? Where are the CDs for sale?
They're back there.
Okay.
We're playing the after party.
We're playing the after party. We owe you La Basanga. But we gotta bust, bring out the other. Billy came for La Basanga. Okay, un pedacito de La Basanga. En el gusto. En especial para nuestro amigo Román.
That's the one I wanted.
Oh. So sonnets are improvised genre, and there's improvisation in the lyrics, there's improvisation in the strumming patterns, and there's improvisation in the melody of the violin as well. The song can last, I mean, they never last 3 minutes. We've made them about 3 minutes each song today, but we could play one song and it would last 3 hours. So this next song, we'll make it a little, we'll try to improvise some verses. We'll try.
We're not warmed up yet.
We're still not warmed up.
It takes an hour.
Well, maybe it won't be a 3 minute song. Maybe it'll be more like 4 or 5 or 6 minutes with some improvisation of the verses.
More
is better. This is my favorite song. It's called El Gusto, and we hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
con la guapanguera, junto con la guapanguera en esta bonita casa. Junto con la guapanguera en esta bonita casa y en esta bonita casa. Junto con la guapanguera. Se los digo y nada pasa, y se los digo a mi manera, saludando a Román Moraza de parte de los Herrera.
Honestly, we were almost starting to get warmed up. It takes a while to get into a, like, I don't know, to get into the groove. Son Huasteco is like different than any other style of music I've ever heard. That everything's kind of like backwards. So I think people either like are in awe of it or you just don't get it. It's like a little, you know. So hopefully you guys were in awe. You say, I get it. I want more of that too. So now we're going to transition into a different son genre. This style of music is from the state of Veracruz, but it would be the southern half of the state of Veracruz. This style of music is called son carocho. I'm sure most of you guys have heard of sones like La Bamba. So it's that style of music. I haven't introduced the individual members of the group, so let me... briefly introduce to my far right, playing the guitar is brother number 4, Juan Pablo. Next to him, playing the toloche or the upright bass is brother number 3, that's Miguel Antonio. Playing the harp is brother number 5, Jose Marcelino. Right next to me, playing the requinto jarocho. And we'll talk a little bit about the instruments in the business. Brother number 1, Jorge Andres. And to my left is the only sister. She always gets more applause than the rest of us. We're all jealous.
Where are you in the birth order?
She's number... last.
The last one.
You're the youngest.
She's 6.
If she was the first, then we wouldn't have any...
Look, I always remember, you are the thorns among the rose.
That is true. We are the thorns. She's the rose. My name is Luis Albino. I'm brother number 2. Good. Second to best. That's what I like to say. Second to best.
Third to third.
They had me and then they wanted more of them, so they continued. Yeah, and then Becca came along and it ended. We could have had a mariachi, we could have had a 15-piece mariachi, but it ended with number 6. Alright, I think I'm tuned. Let's go ahead and kick it off with El Rey de Todos los Sones, El Ziki Ziki. El Chelino!
Thank you.
Gracias. Thank you very much.
Heck yeah.
Heck yeah. That's what we like to hear.
We haven't warmed up yet.
I told them we're not warmed up yet. The next song we're going to play is, I like it so much I named my dog after this song. So we have a habit of naming our pets after songs or sones. So I got a little French bulldog by the name of El Colas. This song is called, this all the way in Fillmore, dedicated to my Colas. El Colas. Chile manito. Thank you. Thank you. We're like, we're there, we're close, we're almost warmed up.
Becca, you're badass.
Becca, you're bad. The next song we're gonna play is different than any other son jarocho. It's the only son in the traditional repertoire that's not 6-8, it's not rhythmic. El colazo is like a 4-4 with like a percussive rhythm. This is actually a waltz rhythm. The so it's a 3-4 and it's a waltz, but it's the Veracruz or Jarocho version of what a waltz is like.
How did a waltz get to Veracruz?
How did an accordion get to Mexico? I don't know. Immigration. No, actually we do know.
Pangea.
You guys can Google colas and Google Pangea.
It came over. Yeah, the French brought it over during the French occupation of Mexico in the 1860s. The Germans brought over in the 18 the 48ers. They came over.
They also brought over their beer
and their meat. That's why we like to drink and we like to make carne asada in Mexico. Yeah. It's the Germans' fault. But.
Yeah. Yeah, Tommy has a lot of German blood in him.
My name is Tomas Herb.
So this song is called La Bruja, and I don't know why, but he always dedicates it to his mother-in-law. Song, and then we'll finish off with a classic that all of you guys are familiar with. This next one is another one of my favorites. It's pretty, it's lively and aggressive and percussive, and I just, this is the one I always ask for. I ask for El Colas and this song. The name of this one is El Pájaro Carpintero. Translates to the Woody Woodpecker. You guys don't know what that is.
Google it.
Yeah. So El Pájaro Carpintero.
¡Vámonos,
paisano! ¡Vámonos, recio! ¡Fuera! Shout out to our mom, if you can hold up our hands. Her name is Oralia, and she was
our Uber in 1980s.
She was our Uber. She was the original Lyft driver, her taxi. A film where she'd take us to soccer practice, piano lessons, violin lessons, basketball practice,
karate,
60 school, Back when gas was at like a dollar a gallon.
We weren't very good at karate. So.
Yeah, we weren't very good at karate. And then our dad,
Georgie.
Jorge Rios. Ah! So our mom would drive us around, but this music we learned in-house with our, she would take us to our classical piano, you know, marching band, jazz band practices, but this style of music and the first style of music we learned in-house with our dad, Jorge, and we still continue to learn from our father, but we also have another teacher in the house. You guys have probably heard him all afternoon, and as the night gets going, you're going to hear him even more. Let's give it up for our Tio Tommy.
Raise your hand.
He's a shy guy. I'll say he's a shy guy. Tio Tommy. You don't want to make eye contact now.
It's like that kid in class that doesn't know the answer.
He's shy now. We want to finish up with El Son de la Bamba. Have you guys heard La Bamba before?
Yeah.
But we want to make it extra special, so we're going to ask our dad to come on up. Another teacher in the house, our Tio Tomas. You guys, come on up. Squeeze through. He gets to take a break. He didn't play the first end. Now he's taking a break.
He's coming. Hold on.
He needs his sombrero. So you gotta come on up here.
We're gonna do a verse, solo. No solo? Verse, short solo? And despedida. Verse. Short solo? Despedida.
Y sigue la matadando. We'll be right back. espalda. ¡Paisano!
Take a short intermission. Did you want to say something?
Yeah, I just want to, is it break time, guys? That's what I thought. Everyone will let you get out before. Okay, so we're going to take a 20-30 minute break like we usually do. Everything's chill. Don't forget to go back and take a look at some of the CDs, and we'll see you all for
and
another set.
Some.
Very soon.
Yeah. Are we back? Get started with our second half.
Go,
the second half.
this
style of music is from northern Mexico. It's known as música norteña. So, playing the drums again, Juan Pablo. Some of the songs will feature saxophone with Jose Marcelino. We got the standard bass, Torloche, played by Miguel Antonio. This is what the Germans brought over, accordion played by Jorge Andres. Our sister, Rebecca. On the percussions. How are you playing bajo quinto? Let's get the party started. We'll be right back.
vivido de un solo
stage that some of you guys had questions about where we played or where you can catch us at next. Is that you? we mostly just play in the comfort of our own home.
So you're all welcome.
Yeah. My dad's
it was
like,
such a privilege to spend that evening in your house and listen to you all play.
Thank you.
Where do all the kids play?
Yeah. Where do we play? We play
Taco Tuesday.
Yeah, Taco Tuesday, El Pescador. We're there on Tuesdays.
Fillmore.
On Tuesdays, and it's this style of music.
El Pescador.
We're gonna continue with another ranchera. Ranchera music is also known as like drinking songs. So go ahead, grab a drink for those of you that have a drink. Salud, you can hold it up. Saludita.
I'm going to go away. repente se lo lleve el viento.
We saw an old friend somewhere in the back. We want to give a shout out to our, I believe he's a foreman.
Antonio!
Where's he at? Oh, there he is. We've known him since he was that tall. Now he's
still,
that tall.
He's still. That's gotcha, man.
Antonio! Marco Antonio, he's a family friend. We've known him his whole life. He's a good friend of ours. And he works here at the Deep End Sessions Ranch.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yep. Runs. Runs. Vamos a continuar. We're gonna continue with. We're gonna change the rhythm. So I think you've heard sones. We played some sones huastecos, huapangos. We played some sones jarochos. There was a couple waltzes. You heard the polka beat, which is traditional to norteño music. We're gonna go a little further south. In Colombia, the cumbia is extremely popular. It made its way north to Mexico. This is a norteño version of the cumbia. ¿Cuál es? Sorry. Échale.
Las chicas las enloquecido, las tortas sonando con tu forma de bailar. Las pelinas no quieren esperar, están esperando al ser quemalador, porque tiene gracia para moverse con sabor. Y le gusta como le mueve el señor. Ya llegó, ya llegó. Las muchachas lindas no quieren bailar, están esperando al ser quemador.
To a different subgenre within norteño music. It's called a corrido. Have you guys heard of a corrido before? A corrido is pretty much it's a narrative ballad, so a song that tells a story. There's like a beginning, middle, end. Sometimes they throw a date in there. There's an introduction. There's an outro. Those are like the traditional elements of the corrido. Over time, it's evolved and it's changed into other things. And for the most part, corridos end in tragedy, so it's like if Shakespeare wrote a norteño song, it would be a corrido. There's your music lesson for the day. This corrido is called, what you want to do?
Juan Marta.
It's about a bandit. I know there's a couple of bandits that live in Santa Paula, so it's dedicated to all the bandidos.
Decían que cargaba el diablo.
Oh,
corrido. We're gonna change rhythms again. So norteño music is like, that's just an umbrella term, and within norteño music, you can play cumbias, you can play norteñas, polcas, you can play rancheras that are 3/4, you can play zapateados, we haven't played a zapateado yet, and you can play boleros. Boleros made their way to Mexico from Cuba. It's usually, they were popular in the 30s and 40s and 50s with trio music. They're still popular. They're still popular. And it was really just, for the most part, this genre lent itself to romantic songs. So this is a very romantic bolero known as Cien Años or 100 Years.
If I lived 100 years, I would love you for 100 years. Say more.
Pasaste a mi lado con gran indiferencia, tus ojos ni siquiera golpearon hacia mí, te vi sin que me vieras. Se ahogó dentro de mí. Me duele hasta la vida saber que me olvidaste, pensar que mi desprecio merezca. Sigue unida mi existencia, y si vivo 100 años, 100 años pienso en ti. Hasta la vida sabe que me olvidaste, pensar que mi desprecio merezca yo de ti. Sin embargo, sigues unida a mi existencia. Song to dedicate on like anniversary or
Valentine's
Day, or on
May 11th.
What is it? May 11th is a good May song. 11th. We're gonna sing it for the mothers, for the mamas, and for the mamacitas.
de las madres, te las cantamos a ti.
So this is a different rhythm. Okay, this rhythm was borrowed from the son genre. So a zapateado is really the same 6-8 rhythm that you hear in son jarocho or sones jaliscienses. So we could take a son de mariachi and make it a norteño zapateado, or we could take a son jarocho or a son michoacano and make it a norteño zapateado. I don't know what zapateado we're going to do. ¿Cuál de todas, Chelino?
¿La vieja?
¿Cuál?
No, la vieja. La loba.
La loba.
Échale.
Que no siente las penas.
Rancheras too. I first heard it with the harpist by the name of Andres Huesca, but many mariachis, bandas, norteños have recorded this ranchera. Tres días, en especial para el amigo Román Moraza.
Román, sing that for you guys.
Too far?
Thank you.
conocer es al invento. Solo tomando me he podido consolar. Ay, 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 ¿yo qué voy a hacer? Si me niegas, alma mía, tu querer. Ay, 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 ¿yo qué voy a hacer?
Circo. He says he wants to play a polka. I think his voice is tired. So a polka is just traditionally musical, no voice or vocals. So this is a traditional polka known as a circo or the circus. It kind of sounds, you can imagine like you're in a circus. It kind of sounds a little like that to me. So el circo, we hope you enjoy it. Chale bonito.
Un, dos,
to invite another awesome performer up on stage. Maybe I know we have a triangle expert in the house, right? Yeah. Let's bring him up here.
Gonna do a last little medley of cumbia, so feel free to dance around the house, and we might feature a triangle solo as well, right?
I'm hanging with Becca.
Thank you very much for having us, and thank you very much, David, for.
Mi gallina siempre está cacaraqueando. Ponle mimito y le hago está cacaraqueando. cacaraqueando. Poneme mi telego, saca cacaraqueando.
Okay. Somos